Hello everyone, we have acclaimed filmmaker Ashwini Iyer Tiwari with us here today. Ashwini, who is known best for Neel Patte Sannata, Bareli Ki Barfi and Panga, is all set to debut as an author with her debut novel, Mapping Love, published by Rupa. Welcome Ashwini.
Thank you Jane.
Ashwini, tell me, since how long has the idea of writing the book been with you?
As a creative person, someone who wants to tell all kinds of stories, you have this creative itch in you that one day I would want to write a novel is because I myself am an avid reader. You travel across the world, you're seeing, going to bookstores. I also remember when I'd gone to Oxford, I just loved the whole vibe of Oxford, and I was roaming around those and went to these really big bookstores, and where you see people sitting on benches and reading, and with the weather there would be like this white window, and through the window there would be this little light where you will see someone who's writing something on their desk, and that whole vibe, and the Shakespeare and Co, Paris, and even in our own country when we want to find the perfect setting to start writing and being in solitude. I wanted to enjoy that. I just do feel that the whole experience of being in solitude, which is different from being alone. Solitude is loving what you do and spending time with that enough to just have a relationship between you and your words. I wanted to enjoy that. And also being a big fan of various authors whose work style I studied and went through, I always felt that, wow, you know, where there is a will, there is a way. And I had the story for Mapping Love and I started writing. But I thought after maybe retiring, when I was retiring, I would start writing a book. But it came pretty early in my life. And I'm very grateful for that. So I'm mapping love with my life right now.
What, according to you, is the toughest part about writing a novel?
For me, the toughest part about writing a novel is discipline. The disciplined writing, which is really important in this day and age where everything is so rapid, and the idea of sitting down and writing and not even looking at that phone for at least 2 hours, or not being knocked on the door, or not having a mind which is wavering, thinking. It has happened with me that I start writing and then I think of all the to-dos which I needed to do.
And what is your favorite time to write?
I think for me, my favorite time would be how the weather is. Like, I'm a night walker. I like walking only after the sun sets. I love the rains. I love walking in the mountains, or I love when the evening is setting down and then you start writing. So maybe 4 to 7 would be the best time I would love to write, is because it's not too hot. You're settling in. The evening light is beautiful. I have a little desk right at the window. So it's nice. It's beautiful to be this there. Yeah.
Through the writing process, who has been your staunchest critic?
I would give the credit to Simar, who is my manuscript editor. When she used to give feedback after I've given her the draft, she would like literally write these sentences. Do you think this is correct? If so, please explain. And there are times when you tend to over-explain, and that's why you need to have amazing manuscript editors around you who support you, who support your vision, but who exactly know where to stop you after a point.
What do books mean to you?
Books means connection. Books means friendship. Books means life. Books means a go-to person when you are really in need of some connection. Books also mean patience. Books also mean knowledge. And when they say a book can be your best friend, is because you can leave the book, but a book will never leave you. Way after long, after years, you can go back and the book will still be waiting for you to open any page you want, and will still, with an open heart, consider you as its best friend.
Any particular writer who inspires your work?
I feel I like a lot of writers. I don't necessarily feel that they would inspire my work. So Murakami, really, I really admire Murakami because even in his magic realism, he talks about a cat and he talks about so many other things where you actually start relating to something which is so unrelatable. Amitav Ghosh, I really like him. I really respect him. It's because he truly standing up for the cause of saving the environment, and he talks about existential crisis of environment, whether it was Calcutta chromosome or whether it is Sea of Poppies, whether it is Gun Island. He also has some magic in his books, is because Gun Island had some kind of magic realism in his writing. But at the same time, he talked about environment. At the same time, he talked about a whole lot of things we question, whether it was migration, whether it is the whole aspect of why am I here at this point of time. You have to keep reading his books time and again to understand that every time you turn a page and you look, see something, read something, and you know that you found something more to take back.
Thank you so much, Ashwini. It was such a pleasure speaking with you.
Thank you so much, Jane.
Subscribe to Midday India. Get direct notifications on all our videos by clicking on the bell icon.